no parties? No, it does not mean no parties. It means no cookies.
Huh?
Yeah, let's just rewind.
27 years earlier.
In 1994, Lou Montulli invented cookies in order to be able to recognize when someone has been on their website and remember their preferences. Fast forward to today, cookies are everywhere. It's hard to browse the internet without them. Or with them. Why is this a problem? Well, users aren't really excited about the fact that websites are tracking their every move and then creepily showing ads or sending them emails based on their behavior, especially when they did not know or consent to this. Could zero-party data be the solution? What even is zero-party data? And how is it different from first, second, and third-party data? And how do you collect it? Well, let's start with the basics, the different types of data parties. First-party data is data collected only by the website you are visiting. For example, if you went onto a website searching for a flamingo costume, the website would be able to track your behavior as long as you are on their website. This includes clicks and in-depth behavior like scrolling, hovering, and time spent on different parts of the website. However, as soon as you leave their website, they can no longer track your behavior. This data is then used by the company to personalize your experience on their website only. The pros about this type of data is that it is unique to your brand and how people interact with your content. It's also free, which is never a bad thing. The cons about first-party data, though, are that it contains very little data on customers' behavior in general, making it hard for you to get a holistic view on your customers' interests and activities. This makes it difficult to accurately personalize your website to different customers. Second-party data is data that comes from another company's first-party data. This is usually purchased from a third-party source and can range from demographics all the way through to email address lists. The pros of this data is that it can enrich your own dataset and give you a complete user profile. However, a very big con is that it tends to be quite expensive. Now, third-party data is the most well-known form of data collection. Probably because it is the one that has caused the most controversy. I mean, GDPR and CCPA laws have been created because of third-party data collection, so it really doesn't have a good rep. Third-party data is essentially data that is shared between web domains. It is the most full-scale dataset that collects data from all your web interactions in order to target ads specific to your interests. As consumer awareness increased about online data privacy, this form of data collection has become more and more problematic. So much that most browsers, many websites, and heavyweight gatekeepers are moving to phase out third-party data collection. In other words, a world without cookies. This is where zero-party data comes in. Zero-party data is data that is obtained simply by asking the customers what their preferences and needs are instead of tracking their online behavior. What a concept! The simplest way to understand zero-party data is to think about what questions a sales representative would ask you if you walked into a shoe store, for example. Their questions would range from what brands you like, what style and color you want, and what shoe size you are. The same answers that you reply to the sales representative in order to identify what product you are looking for are the same answers that zero-party data aims to collect. It allows you to have an honest, transparent, and two-way relationship with your customers by openly asking them what data they would like to share with you. No more creeping or spying required to provide a personalized experience for your customers. So how do you collect zero-party data? You'd be surprised how simple it is. All you need to do is create an interactive quiz, form, or survey asking your customers relevant questions to what they are looking for. This could look like a personality test, a product recommendation quiz, shoppable quizzes, a price quote calculator, or even an onboarding survey. There are several ways to achieve this. You could code an interactive widget for your website, which is a great option because you get to fully design it to your preference. However, the downfall of this is that it tends to be a lot of time and a lot of money. Another option is to use a plugin if you have a content management system. But once again, this tends to be a lot of money and a lot of time. So, what you could use is a no-code builder, which is the quickest and easiest way to do this. And there's no other offer more flexible in design and functionality than InvolveMe. In other words, the zero party don't start till InvolveMe walks in. With our interactive funnels and majestic ready-made templates, you can easily set up a quiz, survey, or form to assist you in collecting your zero party data from your customers. All you need to do is log in or set up an account on the InvolveMe app, and you have access to all our ready-made templates that you can easily customize to your needs. Simply click on templates at the top of your screen and you will see all the available templates, as well as different categories that can help you filter out which interactive funnel you are searching for. A great example of a zero-party data quiz we have on InvolveMe is the shoppable gym shoe configurator, which you can find under the quizzes category. Here, your visitors are guided through a few relevant questions in order to assist them in their product search. If you want to edit one of the templates, you simply need to hover over it and click on Choose. And then you can personalize it to your brand identity. To get started, just simply click on the plus sign at the bottom of your screen, and that will add a new page. Then, in the content elements, you can choose which content element you want to drag and drop onto that page. I'm just going to use the slider element for this page, but you can choose from multiple choice, image answers, rating, and many other content elements. You can also delete any pages you don't want and add as many as you need for your project. However, I would recommend keeping your quiz or survey as short and relevant as possible so you don't overwhelm your customers. Additionally, everything can be customized to your brand identity, including the background image, the text font and style, and the color of the quiz. And with InvolveMe's drag and drop technology, you can create a zero-party data widget for your website, shop, or product quickly and easily. The InvolveMe app really is a unicorn. And to make things even easier for you, you can get 2 months for free on your InvolveMe account by using the link in the description. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you thought it was helpful, and make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time we post a new video. Thanks for watching. Bye. This includes something. Did I mess up my eyebrows?